Let's get back now to NBC's week-long focus on education with two different perspectives. Joining us now is Weili Day. She is co-founder of Marvell Technology Group, a global semiconductor company, and Dennis Van Rokel is president of the National Education Association, the largest teachers union in the company. Welcome to you both. I'm glad to have you here. Weili, how much does technology figure in the solution to our educational problems? Is the solution to give everybody a tablet computer, an iPad, something like that?
Well, first of all, in terms of using technology, today is already becoming consumers part of their life. Mm-hmm. So it is pretty much we're all used to it. Now, the question is, how do we leverage the infrastructure, the use case today as a consumer device, and how do we develop applications on top of those devices? It can empower teacher and make the teaching more effective, as well as make the learning more interesting for students.
You've done a lot, Weili, your company has, and you personally have, in making donations to schools and giving technology to schools and other things. How important is that? Do you think you've helped move the needle?
Well, I think it's it is my passion to support the education system. Look at me as example. Came to this country as a high school senior and got great education. I think it is important for us to help our U.S. education system. I think the key is we need to take the leadership, and hopefully we build an ecosystem where, whether or not from the high-tech industry or the private donors, as well as from government standpoint of view. But the key is, at the end of the day, still depends on the teacher and students. How do they make the education system more robust, meaning we have to develop tools to help teacher and students themselves need to have passion to learn. That's the key.
Mr. Van Rokel, I don't know whether you heard my discussion with Secretary Duncan a few moments ago, but a new poll for NBC and the Wall Street Journal asked people who's more a part of the problem with schools, and obviously this sum is more than 100%. 30% of Americans say teachers are more a part of the problem than of the solution. 50% say parents are more a part of the problem than of the solution. 41% say teachers' unions are more a part of the problem. And 53% in the official piñata of this election season say that elected officials are more a part of the problem. Why do people think teachers' unions are a part of the problem to the extent they do? And is it because the unions generally have opposed such things as pay for performance, merit pay, and transparency of teacher evaluation?
Teacher unions are going to be a major player in as we revamp education. You know, the status quo is not acceptable. Secretary Duncan and President Obama say that all the time. We totally agree. And we're part of that large system. It's a complex system, from a federal government that pays less than 10% of the cost but has very important policies, state government, and that has a major funding responsibility as well as policy, and 15,000 school districts. So there are many pieces to this, but really what makes it work is the interrelationships between all of those. We're part of that system too, and we must be part of the conversation.
Should good teachers be paid more than bad teachers, and should more bad teachers be fired? Time magazine did a poll earlier this year and they found that 43% of teachers in public schools said they knew of a tenured teacher in their school who was incompetent and ought to be fired.
I don't think bad teachers should be paid anything. I don't think they should be in the classroom. We need effective teachers in every single classroom. And it's interesting to see how a country like Finland decided to address that issue. What they do is they recruit high-achieving students in high school, send them to college, pay their way in a five-year program. No one enters the classroom without a master's degree. So what they're saying is, to ensure effective teachers, we're going to make sure that anyone who gets there is qualified and competent. I think that's a good thing to learn from, that we need to look at our recruitment, our training, especially those first 3 to 5 years in terms of the evaluation, tied to good, solid professional development, and it ought to end in National Board Certification.
Yes or no?
That
should good teachers be paid more than poor teachers?
Poor teachers should not be in the classroom. We have a system that pays teachers based on national board certification. They give them extra money. We have systems bargained at different locations where they believe that the teachers should earn more if they go into some of these high-need schools. So there's a lot of differentiation. It's a local decision. They ought to decide how best to do that.
Mr. Van Roekel, thank you very much. And Ms. Dye, thank you as well.
Thank you.
Coming up.